touched me. And all the joy that floods my soul. You see something wonderful happen. He touched me. Oh, Jesus touched me. And oh, the joy, it just floods, it floods my soul. I can't explain it, I don't even understand it, but something wonderful happened, and God, how many of you have been touched by Jesus? You know that your life's been gloriously changed. It's with Jesus' joy that we stand before you tonight. Thank God that over 1900 years ago, Jesus paid a debt that he did not owe, but we owed a debt that we could not pay. And it's because of his shed blood on Calvary that we're seated here tonight, amen? Hallelujah. The blood that Jesus the blood.
that gives me strength from day to day. It will never, never, never lose its power. Oh, I'm glad it reaches to the highest mountain. Oh, and it flows to the lowest valley. Oh, it's the blood that gives me strength.
We have a theme song this week. How many of you sing? How many singers do we have among us tonight? All right. How many of you make a joyful noise? Oh, then you all qualify. Praise the Lord. We have a song that we're going to sing every night, and we're going to become just one great big choir. Is that all right? Now, since we haven't had a rehearsal, all you have to remember are two words. Two words. Only God. Only God. Who do you know that's bigger than a mountain, deeper than the sea, but yet at the same time, he's still small enough to live inside of you and me? Amen? Who can make you smile even when you're feeling bad? Give you joy even when your heart is sad? Only God. Who can take a man, woman, boy, or girl when they're deep in sin, cleanse their hearts, bring them back again? Not mama, not daddy, only God. Hallelujah. Who's bigger than a mountain, deeper than the sea, yet he's small enough to live inside of you and me? Only God, only God, only God. Only God, hallelujah, who can pick you up, hallelujah. He'll even turn you around, yes, he will. Who can place your feet on solid ground? We came to tell you that it's only, no.
it's not the doctor. No, it's not the lawyer. Only God. Only God. No one can feel all of our sorrows. No one can feel all our pain. No one can give our poor hearts ease. No one can give us peace. Save you. Oh, who can heal you? Only God. Hallelujah. Only God. Who can take a man even when he's deep in sin? Oh, who can cleanse his heart? Bring him back again. It's not the doctor. No, it's not the lawyer. Oh, hallelujah. Only yes, who can save you? Who can heal you? Oh, who can keep you? Nobody, nobody but oh, oh, he's my savior. I love him, I love him, I love him. He healed my body and he saved my soul. Oh, hallelujah. Oh, who can save you? Who can heal you? Oh, who can keep you? Yes, hallelujah. One more time. Who can save you? Hallelujah. Father, I love you. I worship and adore. Glorify thy name. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Praise the name of the Lord. Glory to Jesus. You may be seated if you can. How many of you ladies have ever tasted bacon powder? Anybody ever tasted bacon powder? How does it taste? Terrible. By itself. But if you put it in a bowl and then put 2 cups of flour, a couple of eggs, some sugar, some milk, butter, and flavor, and begin to stir it, what do you have? Ha ha. There are those of you that are just tasting the bacon powder of life, and it doesn't taste too good, and that's why you're here tonight. Hallelujah. I've come to let you know that we serve a God who's going to add the missing ingredients to your life. Life is more than just baking powder. Just as sure as you live, just as sure as you submit your life to Him, He's going to add the flour. He's going to add the sugar. He's going to put in the eggs and the butter and the flavor and all of the ingredients and sweeten up your life. He's stirring a miracle for you. What do you need tonight? He's the great I am. And I want to let you know this. God is stirring a miracle for you. It is greater than your need and will last past your time of want. Say that again tonight. God is stirring a miracle for you. It is greater than your need and will last past your time of want. Lord, we confess your word this day. Lord, we say with our mouths and believe in our hearts that a miracle is on its way. We know our needs are met. Is seen, 'cause you're stirring a miracle for me, it is greater than my need and will last past my time. Stir.
Praise God. Thank you, Archie. And we believe God is stirring a miracle for you. Amen. I want you to get ready with your Bibles. Let us stand as we are going to read from God's Word tonight. We will be reading from Revelation, the first chapter of it, right at the back of your New Testament Bibles tonight. Openbaring in die Nuwe Testament, die eerste hoofstuk, vanaf vers 4 tot 8. En terwijl die soen toe blaai, wil ons herinner dat ons morgenochtend 9:30 gaan praat hier myself oor 'n baie belangrike boodskap wat die Here vir ons land en vir ons in gedagte het, namelijk oor die herlewing wat die Here in hierdie land gaan werk en ons in besitname daarvan. En direct na my vir die tweede drie kwart uur sal Mickey Roderick Clark sy getuienis van redding en genesing bring. En ons sal elke persoon in hierdie groot auditorium morgenoggend ook dan bedien met gebed en genesing en soos die Here ons ook al lei. Tonight I will be speaking on the authority of the blood of Jesus. And I hope to speak tomorrow night on the authority of the Holy Spirit. And God has laid a special word for Cape Town on my mouth, in my mouth, but I'm not released to bring it tonight, but I believe that tomorrow night, speaking on the Holy Spirit and the anointing and the gifts, that we will be released to bring that special word for Cape Town. So, ons wil hê dat die môre aand elke Christen, elke vriend, elke persoon wat in die hande kan kry, sal nooi en sal bring, dat ons hierdie saal uitpak. Sondagmiddag, 3:00, het die Here spesiale gebed in my mond gesit vir die families en die huisgesinne van Kaapstad. And I believe on Sunday afternoon at 3:00, the curse will be broken over every single family in this Cape Town area. And I want you to see that your whole family will be here. You start to invite them and bring them, and God is going to stir a miracle for them. Vanaand, Openbaring, die eerste hoofstuk, ek lees uit die Afrikaanse Bybel. We are not going to have interpretation. I'll preach in Afrikaans, English, as the Spirit anoints. I actually need anointing to preach in English. And I believe as I preach in Afrikaans, the Holy Spirit will teach these Americans what I'm saying here. So pray for them too. Openbaring 1, Johannes aan die sewe gemeentes, type van die sewe kerkdispensasies, wat ons ook insluit in. Hy begin dit te sê, genade vir julle en vrede van hom wat is en wat was en wat kom en van die sewe geeste wat voor sy troon is en van Jesus Christus, die getroue getuie, die eerstgeborene uit die dode en die owerste oor die konings van die aarde, aan hom wat ons lief gehad het en ons van ons sondes gewas het in sy bloed en ons gemaak het konings en priesters vir sy God en Vader, aan hom die heerlikheid en die krag tot in alle ewigheid. Amen. Kyk, hy kom met die wolke, en elke oog sal hom sien, ook hulle wat hom deursteek het, en al die geslagte van die aarde sal oor hom rou bedryf. Ja, amen. Ek is die Alfa en die Omega, die begin en die einde, sê die Here, wat is en wat was en wat kom, die Almagtige. Kom ons sluit ons oor. Vader, gee aan elke persoon in hierdie groot auditorium vanaand die geest van openbaring en wijsheid en kennis van onze Heer Jezus Christus. Open ons verstand om die skrifte te verstaan en laat die salving van die Heilige elke juk breek. Holy Spirit, we vow not to take any glory and any honor for what will happen in this meeting tonight. We vow to give you, to give the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit glory and honor. I pray that wisdom will be in every spirit, soul, and mind, that peace will be in this place, and that the sick will be healed by the mighty hand of God the Holy Spirit. Father, we release our faith now for a miracle in every life, in every circumstance, right now, Father, in the name of Jesus. Make me a blessing and a sign to these beautiful people. Amen. Hallelujah. Dankie, kom maar sit. Kan ons net hierdie monitor bietjie so beskuif? Skuif hom net voor na. Skuif hom net so meer so. Hierdie pad, daar sit. Draai hom bietjie so. The authority of the blood of Jesus. Maybe just before I preach, I want to welcome all the people from the Transvaal here. They have come with a bus. Let's give them a good hand of welcome. Amen. Die gesag in die bloed van Jesus. Die gesag in die bloed van Jesus, lieve vriend, broeder en sister, is geweldig groot en het ontzettende waarde. Ek het nou 7, ek is bezig om my vir 7 maanden lang aan die Here nou toe te wy. Ek het begin op die 14 Augustus. God spoke to me during July to separate myself for 7 months unto the Lord, not reading any newspapers, looking to any television, just separating myself from a lot of things and dedicate myself unto God. And I had a wonderful time up to now, but during this time, God very specifically and very afresh gave me some new, fresh insight on the authority of the blood of Jesus. In die boek Hebreërs verwys 25 keer na die werkinge en die krag en die gesag en die invloed van die bloed van Jesus. Van alles wat die apostel Johannes op die eiland van Patmos gesien het met betrekking tot die toekoms en profesie en die hemel en die nieuwe Jerusalem, van alles wat hy gesien het in die laaste boek in die Bijbel, het die bloed van Jesus op hom die grootste indruk gemaakt. Die bloed van Jesus het hom die meeste aangegryp, dat het hom die diepste getref om te sien die kostbaarheid voor die altaar, voor die troon van God, met betrekking tot die bloed van Jesus. Na vanavond, glo ek, sal die bloed van Jesus vir u ook een nieuwe betekenis in u leven bring. Ek glo verder dat die bloed van Jesus vir u een nieuwe gesag en een kracht in u Christenwandel met God gaan bewerkstellig. Alles wat in u leven as een Christen u bevoordeel, alles wat in Suid-Afrika aangaan, elke Christen wat hier sit, elke voordeel wat u geniet, is als gevolg van die gestorte bloed van Jezus. All benefits that we have tonight as Christians are or is because of the blood of Jesus, not because of church affiliation, not because of organization, not because of our membership, not because of our friends, but it is because of the blood of Jesus that we are saved and that our names are written in the Lamb's Book of Life. Amen. Die Here het vir my gewys dat het is tyd dat ons sal ophou soek na een man van bekendheid, dat ons sal ophou soek na kyk na die mens vir hulp, dat ons sal ophou soek na toverhande wat iets besonders kan doen. Dis tyd dat ons sal begin kyk na die offer wat Jesus op Golgotha gebring het. If we can fix our eyes on the blood offer and sacrifice of Jesus of Nazareth on Calvary, we will begin to see God stirring miracles for us, because miracles will happen because of the blood of Jesus. Amen. Well, if you believe it, shout amen. Ek glo vanaand dat ons na die offer moet kyk in hierdie week. Die persoon wat na die evangelist kyk kan teleurgestel word. Ek sê vir u dat niks wat ek doen, al vas ek hoeveel, al bid ek hoeveel, kan u help nie. Dis die bloed van Jesus wat u help. Dis die bloed van Jesus wat u genees. Dis die bloed van Jesus wat u verlos. Dis die bloed van Jesus wat Satan se juke breek. Dis die bloed van Jesus wat gewetens reinig. Dis die bloed van Jesus wat nikotienrokers losmaak en dronkaards nuchter maak en straatvroue godsvroue maak. Dis die bloed van Jesus wat hierdie herlewing in Suid-Afrika gaan bewerkstellig. En iemand het glo, gee die Here hande klap daarvoor. Halleluja. Amen. Numbers 21 verse 9 says that the Israelites had to stare continuously to the tree with the copper snake on that tree. It was a continuous stare, and as they were staring to that tree with that snake on that tree, they were healed from the poison of the snakes that have bitten them. En vanavond wil ek graag hier constateer, dis nie net sommer 'n vinnige kykie na Golgotha nie. Dis nie net sommer so oomlikiese loer na daardie geweldige prys nie, maar dit is deur aanhoudend te kyk, aanhoudend te staar, jou aandag te vestig, nie op 'n mens nie, nie op 'n mens nie, nie op enige instansie nie, maar op daardie bloedoffer wat op Golgotha 2000 jaar gelede gehang het, deur te staar en te kyk na sy wonde, na sy bloed, na sy gebroke liggaam, wat die Here u gaan genees van elke demoon se giftige pik waarmee hy gepik het. Die bloed van Jesus gaan hy genees. Amen. Hallelujah. What did the blood of Jesus bought for us? What is the authority in the blood? And I begin by saying that the blood contains the life of God. It's holy because it comes from God. It comes directly from God the Father. The blood that Jesus shed voluntarily came from God the Father. It was actually the blood of God that was shed on Calvary. God honors the blood of Jesus. Let's all say it out loud. God honors the blood of Jesus. Do you agree with me tonight? Daar moet respek in ons harte kom vir die bloed van Jesus. Ons moet 'n nuwe eerbied hê vir die bloed van Jesus. Baie mense vroetel en stel nie belang nie en laat hulle gedagtes dwaal terwyl oor die bloed bedien word of gelees word. As u nie die bloed eer nie, sal God u nie eer nie. Want God eer die bloed van Jesus. Hy vergewe nie op grond eers van ons gebede nie, maar op grond van die bloed van Jesus. U gaan hemel toe op grond van die bloed van Jesus. God eer die bloed van die lam geweldig. God het die bloed van die lam heeltyd in die hemel voor hom. Ek het 'n visie gehad van die bloed in die afgelope tyd wat op die altaar voor God is reg nou. En ek is hier om vir u te sê reg nou voor God is die bloed van Jesus. And I tell you, I'm standing here with confidence and with boldness, not because I'm somebody, but because I know the price has been paid for this meeting. Your redemption has been bought already. Your healing has been paid for already. Let's give God a good praise for that. Amen. Ons moet die bloed beginne eer en waardeer en besef dit dra gesag voor God en in ons lewens. En soos ons die bloed begin aanwend, gaan die oorwinning begin plaasvind. Ek gaan u help vanaand om na die bloed van die lam te kyk. Ek gaan u help om op grond van daardie bloedoffer in te gaan in die heiligdom. En ek gaan u help om vanaand te vat wat u sin is op grond van die bloed van Jesus. Listen to me. Jesus shed his blood 7 times. Number 1, he shed his blood in Gethsemane when he prayed for us. Secondly, Jesus shed his blood for you in the courtrooms when the soldiers mocked him and hit him with a fist in his face. Thirdly, he shed his blood when a crown of thorns was put upon his head. Vierdens, die Here het sy bloed vir ons gestort toe hy 39 katshoue oor sy rug ontvang het. Vyfdens, het Christus sy bloed gestort terwyl hy met die Via Dolorosa opgestrompel het en talle kere geval het tot op Golgotha se heuwel. Die geskiedenis leer ons dat die dorings sy hoof laat swel het, dat hy dikwels met sy gesig in die grond geval het terwyl hy daar die kruis gedra het. En die Bybel leer ons dat hy die 6de keer sy bloed gestort het toe hy gekruisig was aan daardie vrede kruishout. Die 7de keer wat hy sy bloed gestort het was toe die spies in sy sy gesteek was en sy hart gepenetreer het en water en bloed uit sy sy gevloei het. Jesus shed his blood 7 times, which is the number of perfection, to shed and pay the perfect offering and price for the victory of his people. And I'm here to tell you, it's not necessary for you to be sick. It's not necessary for you to carry the load of sin. It's not necessary for you to be defeated. After this meeting, you will have the victory in your heart. Hallelujah! Die Here het my net 'n paar gedagtes gegee oor die bloed en ek gaan dit vinnig afhandel. Die salwing van die Here is sterk. Hier gaan wonderwerke by die honderde plaasvind. The blood firstly gives us authority, and the blood firstly was shed in the first place for our sins to be forgiven. En ons het dit dikwels gehoor, geloop die tyd wys die Here my iets niets. Hy wys my die bloed en hy sê vir my, dis nie 'n kwessie van dat my sonde vergewe gaan word nie. Dis 'n kwessie van my sonde is vergewe. Dit is 'n geweldige belangrike saak. Let's understand it. When we look to the blood declares something. It tells us something. It shows us something. And it says, your sins are forgiven. En ek gee nie vanaand om of u 'n moordenaar is, en of u nou net 'n leuen vertel het, of vroeër vandag gesteel het nie. As u vanaand opkyk na die bloed van Jesus, spreek die bloed met gesag. Jou sonde is vergewe. Halleluja. Prys die Here. Waai net 'n bietjie hand en sê net amen. Because of the blood, I can say I am righteous. Because of the blood, I can say I am forgiven. We have a sin conscience problem in this place tonight. The people are used to the fact that if they come to church, they must hear how bad they are, how many sins they did, and they must receive forgiveness. I'm here to tell you tonight that the blood is of such authority that it speaks not of condemnation, but of forgiveness right now in this place. Come on, give the Lord a good clap offering. Jesus was more than a sin offering, sir. The Bible teaches that God made Jesus sin. Did you hear me? God het Jesus sonde gemaak. He was actually made sin with our sins. And he was actually made unrighteous with our unrighteousness. Hier sit baie ongeregtigheid. Hier is baie mense teenwoordig wat nie 'n regheid pad met die Here wandel nie. Hier is baie mense teenwoordig wat selfs as Christene nog steeds geheime sondes het. Hier is baie mense teenwoordig vanaand wat nog steeds, die Here wys my dit reg nou, wat nog steeds vashou aan dinge uit hulle verlede. Maar ek is hier as God se diensknegt nie om u of iemand hier op die platform te behaag nie. Ek is hier om sy boodskap waarvoor ek ure en dae gebid het vir u te bedien, en hy sê u moet vanaand kyk na die bloed van Jesus.
dit spreek van volkome vergifnis en reiniging en suivering en verlossing en heiliging, dat hy hier sal uitstap, een nieuwe mens. Halleluja.
He was, let's all say it, Jesus was our sin substitute. I want you to say it again. Jesus was my sin substitute. Taking our place. Being made sin with our sin. He went to the prison which sinners were sentenced to, and suffered until everything against us had been met. En ek staan hier voor u en ek sê vir u vanavond, in hierdie auditorium, nie môre nie, nie eers Sondag nie, vanavond, wil ek dit in jou hart inbrand, dat Jesus Christus in die gevangenis van sonde gestraf was, totdat elke straf betaal was en elke skuld betaal was vir u, en dat u vanaand hier kan uitstap sonder sonde, sonder 'n vuil gewete, sonder 'n bekommernis oor hoe ek voor God moet staan. Die bloed gee jou gesag om hier uit te stap en te skreeu, ek is vergewe, ek het geregtigheid by God ontvang. Well, come on! I want to hear you praise God for the victory! It was deity suffering for humanity, and his blood is right now before God on the altar to cleanse all 6, 5, 7,000 people in this place in 1 second, and wash us whiter than the snow. Well, come on! Amen. The devil doesn't like this preaching, brother. He wants us to walk bent down, burdened with a bad conscience and with self-condemnation. But this is the word of God for tonight. This is the power of the gospel, that the blood of Jesus can take away sins and cleanse you and make you the righteousness of God. Come on! Now stand and give Jesus honor for the blood that he has shed on Calvary. Woo. Amen. Hebrews, the 10th chapter, verse 17 says that the blood take our sins away in such a manner that God can't even remember it. Amen. That's the new covenant. Raise your right hand, Christian, and say, this is the new covenant. God cannot remember my sins. The blood of Jesus has forgiven me. Hallelujah. This is good news to the sinner. This is good news to the backslider. This is good news for South Africa. I tell you, the world is condemning us. And the devil is accusing us, but we look up to the blood of Jesus tonight, and we shout the victory because the blood has been shed.
Come on, let's give God a good hand.
Die Bybel sê in Openbaring die eerste hoofstuk, aan hom wat ons lief gehad het, en ons van ons sondes gewas het. Ek is so blij dat ek vanavond in die goeie hoop kan preek vir elke dokter, prokureur, werklose, courantmanne, pastore, christene, besoekers, dat die bloed van Jesus was ons van al onze sondes. One of the biggest problems is that we always walk self-righteous and say we do not have sin. We all have sinned. And I tell you, no church, no doctor, no psychiatrist, no hospital, no evangelist can heal you from your sins. It's through the blood of Jesus Christ alone that you can receive the miracle of a complete cleansing of heart. The heart, let's all say, the heart is the offspring of life. And your heart, every day, you must apply the blood to your heart. Otherwise, your life will be contaminated by the things of this world. But every day, not only tonight, every single day after today, you can apply the blood and trust Jesus to wash your heart, which is the offspring of your life, and you can walk before God a cleansed, a washed child of the living God. Come on now. I want to close this first part before I go on. I want everybody to raise their right hands and say with me tonight, through the blood of Jesus, I have forgiveness. Hallelujah. Isn't it good? Can you sense the mighty presence of the Holy Spirit all over this place? Amen. Tweedens, en ek haas my, die bloed van Jesus Christus waarborg gesag, nie net van in vergifnis nie, of van vergifnis nie, maar dit waarborg ons gesag oor die werke van die duivel. The blood of Jesus has authority over all the power of the devil. Glory to God. Ek sê vir Mieke Rodriekaak hier op die platform, ek sê vir Mieke, ek is so rustig voor hierdie diens. Ek is skoon bekommerd dat ek so rustig is. Maar jy sien, ek is omdat ek al heel dag met hierdie boodskap bezig is. Jy verstaan? En die Bybel sê in Hebreërs 2:14, aangesien die kinders dan vlees en bloeddeelagtig is, Hebreërs 2:14, het Christus dit ook op diezelfde manier deelagtig geword, zodat hij door die dood op Golgotha hom tot niet kon maak wat mag oor die dood het, dit is die duivel, en allemaal kon bevry. Die engel sê, that through death Jesus might destroy him who had the power of death, that is the devil, and release those who were subject to bondage. But a couple of other translations in the 26 translations Bible say these words. One translation says that through death Jesus might destroy him that had power over death, that is the devil. Another translation says that in order that by his death he might dethrone the devil. Another translation says that through his death Jesus might paralyze the devil. Another translation says that by dying he might, well, it's the Moffat's translation, and the Connie Bear translation says that by dying Jesus might
crush the lord of death, that is the devil.
Let me tell you something. I am not going in this place, and you are not going through your works and ability to crush the devil. The blood of Jesus is our authority, it's our guarantee, it's our faith foundation that the devil, the Lord of death, will be crushed and paralyzed in this auditorium tonight. Amen. Die bloed van Jesus breek Satan se hou vas. Waar hy nog vashou met 'n katarak, daar verlam hy net. En hy moet los en die oog moet oopgaan. Waar hy nog 'n oor toedruk, daar moet hy los, want die bloed van Jesus verlam elke demoon. Dit vernietig die werke van Satan. And you must never go before your adversary thinking that you will have the victory because you are somebody. No, you are looking to the blood of Jesus. And because of the blood, we apply the blood. And because of the blood, we have overcome by the blood of the Lamb and the word of our mouth. Is that right? Kom ons sê dit net almal saam. Through the blood, I have power and dominion and victory over the devil. Sê dit so 'n bietjie harder. Ek het gesag deur die bloed van Jesus oor die dood en oor die duiwel. U wat vanaand hier sit, beroerte leiers, polio leiers, die dood wat jou aangetast het, se gesag is gebreek deur die bloed van Jesus reg nou. Amen. Sickness is a form of death. If you cannot use your arm is dead. If you cannot use your leg is dead. If you cannot use your eye is dead. But the Bible teaches that because of the death and the blood of Jesus Christ, death has been paralyzed. The Lord of death, which is the devil, not God, is being paralyzed through and by the power of the blood of Jesus. And he's crushed. And because of the blood, you can get that dead arm working again. Amen. Let's say the blood contains the life of God. Sê dit bietjie in Afrikaans, die bloed van Jesus het die lewe van God in dit. En broeder en suster, jy moenie na my kyk of na die predikers kyk of na iets anders kyk nie. Kyk vanaand op na die bloed op die altaar voor God en weet daar die dooie arm kan weer beweeg. Daai dooie been kan weer beweeg. Daai dooie oog kan weer lewe. Want Jesus het gekom om te gee lewe en oorvloed daarvan. Halleluja. Amen. Ek wil my haas. Thirdly, third authority in the blood of Jesus is his blood sufferings make us brethren of each other and family of God. Hebreërs 2 vers 11 sê, want dit het God hom betaam ter wille van wie alle dinge die wie alle dinge is, as hy baie kinders na die heerlikheid wou bring om die bewerker van hulle saligheid deur lyde te volmaak. Ek het vir u gesê Jesus het 7 keer gely vir ons. Wat heilig maak, sowel as hulle wat geheilig word, is almal uiteen. En om hierdie rede skaam hy hom nie om hulle broeders te noem nie. Ek is so bly Jesus skaam hom nie om my 'n broeder te noem nie. Daar is ander ouens wat hulle skaam. Some of them are not even in this church tonight. Because they are ashamed to call me brother. But Jesus, because
he became flesh and blood. And God perfected him through sufferings and through that blood offering. He is not ashamed to call us family. En ek sal nou elke arm en vat wat ek kan kry hier. Want ek wil vir u sê, dis tyd dat die kerk van Jesus Christus verby mekaar se foute in kerkkaartjies kyk en hande vat en broeders word. Ons is deur een bloed gekoop en deur een bloed gewas. Ek het na hierdie Kaap gekom. Bedroef het, waar ek julle te nagekom het, ek vra om vergifnis, ek wil hê ons moet broers wees, julle moet nie skaam wees om my broer te noem nie, en ek wil nie skaam wees om julle broers te noem nie. Amen. It's time for us to be brethren. Halleluja. Woo. Praise God, he's colorblind, he's only seeing the blood of his son. Amen. We are brethren tonight in Cape Town. If you are not ashamed to call me brother, raise your hand and shout, I love you. If you don't want to say it, I'll make you say it. Amen. Maar u is my broers deur die bloed van Jesus. Ons is nie hier in 'n eenheid, hier is honderde kerke by mekaar. Maar die geheim is vanaand, die bloed van Jesus maak ons broeders van mekaar en broeders van hom wat sy lewe vir ons afgelê het. Come on, you have an elder brother. Say, Jesus is my elder brother. Come on, praise him. Go ahead and praise him. Woo, go ahead and praise him. Glory to God. Amen. Number four, the fourth authority in the blood of Jesus. Die vierde gesag, dit reinig ons vlees. Want die Bybel sê in Hebreërs 9, as die bloed van stiere en bokke en van os heilig maak tot reiniging van die vlees, hoeveel te meer sal die bloed van Jesus ons nie reinig in ons gewetens nie. Is u met my? Luister mooi, sê saam met my, so hard as wat u kan. Through the blood of Jesus, I have forgiveness. Say secondly, through the blood of Jesus, I have victory over the devil. Thirdly, say, through the blood of Jesus, I am part of the family of God. And now fourthly, say, through the blood of Jesus, I have soundness of body. Amen. As die bloed in die Ou Testament van bokke en osse vlees kon reinig, hoeveel te meer kan die bloed van Jesus nie ook u liggaam reinig van siektes en van krankhede en van pyn, en melaatsheid, en dood, gloei in daardie kragtige bloed. As u nie meer glo nie, gaan u glo na vanaand. Amen. Die bloed van Jesus, die bloed van Jesus, bring vir ons genesing vir ons liggame. The blood of Jesus makes God your healer. Wanneer God na die bloed kyk, maak dit God u geneesheer.
As u vanavond na hierdie boodskap kyk, ek wil nie praat net van hoor nie, u moet het kan sien. As u kan kyk na die bloed van Jesus, sal daar die bloed vir u sê, jy is genees. Luister, ek hoor, ek hoop u snap en hoor wat ek sê. Want die Here hoor wat ek sê. En ek sê dit nie ligtelik nie, ek sê dit as woorde van God. Die bloed van Jesus spreek nie van genesing wat kom nie. Dit spreek, as jy dan dit kyk en jy sien dit, dan spreek dit alreeds, dat dit was gestort, dat jy gezond kan wees, kan bly en is. Halleluja. Now notice with me carefully that the blood of Jesus is right now. Let's all say it right now. Right now on the altar of God. It's not a question that somebody is preaching some other ritual or theological idea here. Right now, the blood of Jesus is before the altar of God. God right now sees the blood. And Jesus right now is bringing his blood in the presence of God. I believe with silver or golden buckets, throwing it on the altar of God and say, Father, for the healing, the forgiveness, the cleansing, the victory of the people in the Good Hope Center, of Nikki van der Westhuizen and his team, and every child, man, woman in this place, the blood right now speaks for our healing and our victory. Come on now, will you just wave your right hand if you believe it? Glory. Reg op hierdie oomblik is die bloed voor God. Het gevloei uit die wonde van Jesus. Ek was in Mauritius gewees, 2 weke terug, 10,000 mense daar op die diens, Hindus, Moslems, atheïste, kranksinniges, siekes. En ek het hulle een vraag gevra, ken julle Hindus en Moslems en mense hier, iemand wat al sy bloed gestort het en laat vloei het om jou te help en te red uit jou benauwdhede, uit jou siektes, uit jou bekommernisse, uit jou financiële nood, en 10,000 mense kon nie een hulle hand opsteek nie. Maar ek het vanavond vir u goeie nuus hier en die goeie hoop. Ek weet, hier is niemand wat sy bloed vir u gestort het nie, maar ek weet van een, wat verwond was, vir ons, wat siekte gemaakt was, wat u koors gedra het, die blindheid, die pijn, die leiding, die benauwdheid. Hy was so benauwd dat hy geskreeu het, o God, waarom het hy my verlaat? Dit het pik donker nag om geword. Hy was tussen die misdadigers, daar was op hom gespoeg en gevloek en geskel. Hy was geswel, hy het knoppe gehad, hy het swelsels gehad, hy het pijn gehad, en ek wil vir u sê, wanneer jy vanavond na die bloed kyk, dan kyk jy vas binnen in jou genesing, jy kyk vas binnen in jou voorsiening, jy kyk vas binnen in jou oorwinning, jy kyk vas binnen in jou vreugde, jy kyk vas binnen in die heerlijkheid van God, halleluja. I say it's done.
Let's shout it, it's done. Let's shout it, it's done. Let's shout it again, it's done.
We are not here to ask healing. We are here to say, Father, I thank you. Jesus, by your stripes, I was healed. Amen.
Ons sit nie vanavond hier en smeek nie. En luister vir my. Listen to me carefully. I've made a study of it. New Testament praying is not a lot of supplication. But New Testament praying is declaration. Let's say it. New Testament praying is declaration. Vanaand in hierdie plek sukkel ons nie om wonderwerke of genesing of vergifnis te kry nie. Ons kyk na die bloed van Jesus en ons maak ons monde oop en ons sê, Here, ek prys u. Dit is myne. Dit is voorsien. My hand kom los. My liggaam kom los. Here, ek gaan hierdie siekte dra nie. U het dit gedra. Ek het vanaand die voorreg om 'n gesonde liggaam te hê. Kan ons die Here nie net aanbid nie? Oh God. Oh God. I sense God is already healing people all over this place. There's a special anointing of healing right now. God has called me to minister healing, not because I am somebody, but because the price has been paid. Amen. And I've got a special compassion for the sick. We have advertised this crusade as a miracle crusade because the greatest miracle is the forgiveness of your sins. But together with it, also the healing of your sick body. Amen. Hier sit vanaand kankerleiers. U moet gereed kom vir 'n wonderwerk. Begin na die bloed van die lam kyk. Hier sit mense met vergroeisels op die bors, op die rug, bochels, stywe arms, knoppe. U moet begin kyk na die bloed van Jesus. En moenie net kyk nie, begin sê, ek neem die bloed van die lam. Dis myne. Ek verklaar genesing. My liggaam kan gesond wees. Amen. Ek sal u sê, die kerk van Jesus het 'n terugkeer in genesing nodig. Die duiwel probeer genesing afmaak. En God vergewe my en ons almal se ongeloof. Dis tyd dat ons begin glo. Dis nie 'n man nie, dis die Here. Hy is Jehovah Rafa, die God wat gesond maak. En ons geloof vrystel vir wonderwerke in ons reistoele, in ons oë, in ons lewens, in ons lewers, in ons vergroeisels. Amen. Listen to me closely. Listen to me closely. You look to the blood tonight, not to a man, and you begin to declare, I am righteous and forgiven. You begin to declare, I am more than a conqueror. You begin to declare, I am part of God's family. You begin to declare, by His stripes, I am healed. And you take that blood, you apply it, you take it, and you resist the devil with the blood, not with your own abilities, but with the blood, and see what the blood of Jesus Christ will begin to do in heaven and in earth. Amen. Vanaand, ek voel ek gaan nie verder, veel verder kan bedien nie. Die Here se lieflikheid is reg oor hierdie tabernakel. But I want to just close in this and say, let us all say it out loud. By His blood, I have success. Amen. Amen. Hoor jy, ons is nie 'n klomp verloorders nie. Ons is 'n wennerskerk. Amen. Ons is 'n wen gemeente. Ons is 'n wen volk.
By his blood I have success. Because the reason Galatians 3 declares that the blood of Jesus redeemed us from the curse of the law. Come on now. Jy wat nie Engels verstaan nie, luister mooi. Ek verstaan self nie altyd Engels nie. Maar ek sê vir u, die vloek het ons gemaak mense met tekortkoming, Here. Van u wat hier sit, tekortkoming, Here, in die huwelik. Tekortkominge in u finansies. Tekortkominge in u liggaam. Tekortkominge in u bediening. En mense, the curse of the law is the curse of falling short. Falling short in finances. Falling short in your marriage. Falling short in your self-image. Falling short in your health. Falling short in your faith and in your ministry. But I want to say something in this place tonight. The Bible teaches cursed is everyone that hangs on a tree. And Jesus Christ hanged on the tree on Calvary. And he took the curse upon him. He took our falling short upon him. And the blood of Jesus guarantees success for God's people. Come on now. Say hallelujah. Say praise the Lord. Amen. The Bible teaches that one of the names of God is Jehovah Jireh. En as jy daardie woordjie vertaal, Jehovah Jireh, dan beteken het the one who sees. Die een wat sien. Dis by implikasie wat het beteken. En dit beteken God sien u behoeftes. Jy hoef het nie eens vir my te sê vanavond nie. God sien u in hierdie plek. He's Jehovah Jireh. He sees your need before you know of it. Come on. God sees what things we have need of before we ask. Abraham stapt in die berg op, hy sê, die seun sê, hier is vuur, hier is hout, maar waar is die offerlam? Abraham sê, God sal voorsien. Amen. Jy sal vanavond sê, wel hier is dit, hier is dit, hier is dit, maar waar is dit? God sal voorsien. Amen. En ek wil vanavond vir u sê, dat deur die bloed van Jesus kan u sukses hê in die huwelik. Jy kan sukses hê in jou finansies. Jy kan sukses hê in jou liggaam. Jy kan sukses hê in jou verhoudinge. Sukses in jou besigheid. Godse mense behoort die mense op die aarde te wees. Amen. We have the ability of God. We have the wisdom of God. We have the mind of Christ. We shouldn't be the guys that make the money. Die stilste wat het nog hier was in hierdie groep sien. Nou, aangezien ek het klaar gesê, kan ek het net sowel klaar maak. Ek dink die tyd van armoed is voorbij, voorbij van Godse mense. Want hulle gaan daar na daar die kruis beginne kyk. En hulle gaan hoor wat Paulus in Korintiërs geskryf het. Hy het arm geword, dat ons kan ryk word, en hulle gaan bly kyk, en bly glo, en bly sien, en begin optree, and brother, the wealth of the wicked will come to God's people. Come on now! Yes, sir. The blood of Jesus gives us success. Amen. I want to promise you, this is going to be one of the most successful crusades you've ever sat in. Not because of any one of us or our organizational ability, but right on the first night, we are going to look to the blood of Jesus and say, Father, through that blood, we claim revival for this Cape Town area. Through the blood, we cast out every principality, every devil, every demon, every form of resistance. Through the blood, Father, I take my forgiveness. I take my healing. I take my miracle. God is stirring a miracle because of the blood of Jesus. Well, give the Lord a good clap offering. Woo! Ek is klaar. Die Here is hier. Brother Henry, will you just softly minister on the piano? Oh, we are just going to flow right into this miracle service and believe God for healings, salvation, success, victory, deliverance. Amen. Are your heart happy tonight? Is jou geloof versterk in hierdie plek? Het die woord vir jou iets gedoen in hierdie tabernakel? Sê vir die persoon langs jou, die woord het vir my iets gedoen in hierdie plek vanaand. Amen. Luister vir my, ons gaan nou allemaal, al hierdie duisende mense, gaan nou instap voor die heiligdom van God en in die teenwoordigheid van God. Ek wil doodse stilte hê. Ek wil geen barbecue oor huil en geen mens sien beweeg nie. If you move around right now, you are not honoring the blood of Jesus. Ek wil geen geluid hê, al raak die Here jou ook aan, hou jou mond net vir 'n oomblikie stil. God wants order in the miracle meeting. Because the Holy Spirit is a spirit of order right now. And He's going to move for us. But I'm in closing tonight. Hebrews 10:19. Therefore, brethren, having boldness to enter the holy place by the blood of Jesus. Kyk vir Pastor Nikki. Deur die bloed van Jesus het ons vanaand vrymoedigheid. Hebreërs 10:19. Nou dan, broeders, terwyl ons op die nuwe en lewende weg kan ingaan deur die bloed van Jesus wat vir ons gesprinkel was, laat ons toetree met vrymoedigheid. Baie mense wat hier sit kan nie bid nie. As ek 'n toets moet maak, hoeveel mense bid 1 uur per dag? Gaan nie eers 10% hulle hande hier opsteek nie. Meeste van u het nie vrymoedigheid om met boldness in te stap in die heiligdom van God en te gaan vra en gaan bid en verklaar en aanbid wat aan jou behoort nie. En daarom vanaand, die bloed van Jesus gaan u vrymoedigheid gee. Luister vir broenietjie. Nie u status, u gebedsenergie, die manier waarop u bid, hoe hard of sag u bid, vat jou in die heiligdom van God nie. Net die bloed van Jesus alleen vat jou elke keer in die heiligdom van die Vader. Het jy my gehoor in hierdie plek van? Listen to me. Our boldness to enter into the throne room of God is not our energy. It's not our spiritual ability to pray. It's not our church label that takes us in. Of het maandag of sondag is, of in die motor of in die huis, dis die bloed van Jesus wat jy elke keer by die Vader uitbring.
om met hom te praat. Amen. In hierdie plek recht nou, gaan ons met die Vader praat. Allemaal van ons. En ons gaan voor hom kom in aanbidding. En ons gaan hom vertrouw vir elke wonderwerk, vir elke geneesing, vir elke aanraking van die Heilige Gees in hierdie plek. Die Heilige Gees is een persoon, hy is hier. Hy is net soos ek, ons kan hom net nie sien nie. Maar hy het vorm. Hy is een persoon. As hy sy hand op jou sit, sal jy vanavond gewaar. Kankers droog op, siektes verdwijn, pijn gaan weg. Die hitte van sy kracht en vrede sal jy vanavond versterk. Hy is hier, recht nou. Ek wonder of ons recht oor die plek ons handen net kan oplig, al twee, terwijl ons voor God in aanbidding kom. Celestial glow, there is peace and rest and love. Jesus is in this place. Hier is een zwaar en een geweldige sterk salwing van die Heere om mense te genees wat aan kanker lê en wat knoppe en zwelsels en vergroeisels en verborring in hulle lichaam ervaar. I tell you, there's a strong anointing to heal you of growths and arthritis and knops and twisting and withered arms, and I tell you, I just sense God, the Holy Spirit is just moving in that area. If you have a swollen part in your body, swollen gland, or a growth, or a knob, just touch it softly and apply the blood of Jesus upon it. See it healed through the blood of Jesus. Reg op iemand se bors is daar 'n vergroeisel wat die Here aanraak. Ook op iemand se rug aan die regterkant gewaar ek die Here raak vergroeisels aan. Kankers, knoppe word sag. Kom ons sing het terwyl ons die Here aanbid. Oh, the blood of Jesus. Yeah. Halleluja. O, die Here se soete teenwoordigheid. Elke een wat 'n vergroeisel, 'n knop, 'n gewas, 'n geswel in die liggaam het. Verdorde arm of been of liggaamsdeel. Die krag van die Here is hier.
die rechterkant, die linkerkant vooral, baie sterk vir genesing in daar die area. Hou die hand op daar die gewas of vergroeisel. God is going to heal it just like that. I want all the people with growths and goiters and swollen parts in their bodies just to stand quickly to your feet. Right now I'm going to do a special prayer for you. And we just believe God to touch you. Will you quickly come out, sir? Quickly, come out, sister. Kom staan net hier vinnig voor.
He was bruised for our iniquities.
Surely he bore.
Surely.
Staan in 'n lang rij, skouer aan skouer. Ik zal graag van mijn werkers en hofmeesters hier wil hê. Ek gaan nie vra wat bekeer nie. Nie ander siekes nie, net vergroeisels. Net geswelde mense, mense met kanker. As die blind of doof of krepel is, moet nie nou kom nie. Ons gaan vir al die ander siekes nou bid. Net vergroeisels. Werkers, staan net vinnig achter hierdie mense. Ek gaan nie vir die vra wat die bekeer nie. Sit die hand op die plek waar die geswel of die vergroeisel is. Reg nou. Ek gaan net my hande vinnig op die sit. Die Here gaan die ander aan. Father, let there be a miracle in this body. Right now, Jesus. Right now, Jesus. I thank you, Lord. I curse every growth. I curse every growth. I curse every growth. I curse it, Father. I curse it, Jesus. I curse it. In the name of Jesus, let there be a mighty miracle. Let's begin to give Jesus a clap offering for every miracle. Jesus, Jesus. Amen. Come on, all over this place. Let the power of God. Amen. He was wounded. Lift your hands. Begin to pray. Touch your own body. All my workers and counselors and pastors, come right down. Stand between these people with the knobs and the swollen parts in their bodies. Will you take your hands and put it on them quickly right now? Counselors, just come out, run quickly. Come and stand. Walk into these people. Lay your hands upon them right now. I just sense God is healing people all over this place. Pastors, I want you to come down and begin to pray for these people. Cursed. Counselors, just press through. Come around and press through. Hierdie mense hiervoor, begin bid vir jouself. Die Here se krag is op u vir 'n genesing. Vader, ons neem gesag oor elke vergroeisel, oor elke klop, oor elke kanker, oor elke swelsel. Ons kom daarteen in die naam van Jesus. En Vader, ons vra in u naam dat hier 'n heling sal plaasvind. 'N Genesing. Ons kyk na die bloed van Jesus. Ons kyk na die bloed van Jesus. En ek sê vir hierdie knoppe en swelsels en vergroeisels, klaar op. Klaar op. Wees gepunt. You foul demons of growth. You foul demons of growth and cancer. You foul evil spirits. In the name of Jesus Christ, be bound. Loose these bodies. Come out. Right now, come out. Come out in the name of Jesus. And Father, we lay our hands on these people. We touch them with a miracle touch of the Holy Spirit. We touch them with a miracle touch of the Holy Spirit. Father, let your resurrection power be upon them right now. Let every growth vanish. Let every cancer die. Let the blood of Jesus be applied to their bodies. Let there be a miracle of healing, Lord. It's happening right now. Let's begin to take it. Let us all stand and begin to take it. Kom ons staan almal, ons begin dit te vat. Kom ons begin die Here te loof. Kom ons begin die Here te prijs. Amen. Allemaal in die plek gee die Here net een groot handeklap. Hiervoor, vat jou genezing en begin God te prijs daarvoor. Amen.
And all the joy that floods my soul.
Glory to God. Amen. Let's sing it softly with Archie. Close your eyes. Keep on receiving.
He touched me and made me whole.
Everybody now.
He touched me.
Sing it and praise God. Zijn toppen wordt zag en het verdwijnt. Vat nou aan die top. Druk op hem. Hij zal zag worden en weggaan in Jezus naam.
Oh, he touched me.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus. Listen to me. Let's get it softly. Listen. God is in this place. All over this place. God is going to heal people. I want all my counselors to turn around to the audience and just look to the audience. Counselors and workers. Pastors, just look to the audience. If there are people in the audience with blind eyes, raise your right hand. Let me see it. Come on. Keep up your hand. In front also, if you have a blind eye, raise your right hand. If you have a deaf ear, raise your right hand. Let me see. If you have a deaf ear, let me see. Sir, are you deaf? Net die mense wat doof is, steek je rechterhand hoog op, laat ik zien. Hou dit daar. Bring hy man hier. As jy doof in jou linker oor, kom op die platform. Jy wat blind en doof is, hou jy rechterhand hoog op, ooral in die vertrek. Jy wat enige ander siekte, kwaal, pijn, verlamming, polio het, hou jy rechterhand hoog op. Ons wil so sê, as jy siek is, bly staan. As jy nie siek is nie, sit. If you are sick, keep standing, remain standing. If you are not sick, just sit down. And these people, if you are healed from a growth or a goiter or a swollen part in your body, come to that side and come and tell us what God has done. If God has healed you, come to that side. If you are healed, come to that side or this side quickly. The rest of you just go and take your seats quickly. Counselors, walk right into the rest of the audience and go and stand by the sick people in their chairs. Sal die counselors net reguit beweeg na die mense wat bly staan, wat siek is. As u gesond is, gaan staan op die punt en ons wil hoor wat die Here vir u gedoen het. As die Here u al reeds genees het, of vergroeisels is weg, of knoppe is weg, of zwelsels is weg, kom staan op die punte. Die rest gaan sit net. Die wat in die banke is en die siek, bly staan. are sick, just remain standing. Remain standing in front or remain standing in your seats. Counselors and pastors, would you just walk out between these sick people here and in the chairs? Go into your sections and let's trust God for miracles. We need some counselors to lay their hands on the people in the wheelchairs right now, quickly. Let's sing it all together. He touched me. Oh, He touched me. Nou bid, reg oor die plek as u siek is, staan, en iemand gaan by jou kom staan, en sy hande op jou sit, die Here gaan u aanraak, een aanraking van die Here gaan op u wees, kom ons neem allemaal geloof, kyk na die bloed van Jesus, as u siek is en u staan, en daar is nie een helper by u nie, sal u net die hand waai, laat ons net sien. If you are standing and there is not a helper with you, just wave your hand, let me see. There on the top balcony, we need some more counselors and workers to go up to that area. Thank you. Everybody right in front, there's somebody with you to minister. We are ready for a miracle. Hallelujah. Ek wil hê dat almal in hierdie tabernakel oë sal sluit. Saggies begin bid vir die siekes. Archie Dennis, I want you to sing God is stirring a miracle for you just once. Just sing it one time.
God is stirring.
Werkers, begin jou hande op daardie mense te lê.
A miracle for you.
Begin hulle saggies te bedien. Vra hoe sal hulle weet dat hulle gesond is? Going to pray and trust God for a miracle. Hemelse Vader, ons aanbid U. Alle Christen in hierdie plek aanbid U. Dankie vir die bloed van Jesus wat gevloei het vir hierdie aand. Vader, ek bedank U uit my hart uit dat hierdie gebed hoor. Ek dank U dat ons allemaal in die heiligdom kan kom staan met ons behoeftes. In die naam van Jesus dra ons elke sieke aan U op, Here. Ons vra dat daar genesing, Here, uit U hande en deur die hande van elke werker sal vloei. Selfs by hulle wat nie 'n werker by hulle het nie, laat daar genesing vloei. Ons kom vanaand in Jesus naam op die bloed van die Lam van God. En ons lê ons hande in die geloof op elke siek liggaam. Ons kom teen blinde duivels, ons sê, jou gees van blindheid, jou tyd is verby. Wees gepunt in elke katarak oog, in elke blinde oog, in elke skeel oog, in elke swak siende oog. Gebied ek jou in Jesus naam om uit te kom. Ek sê ook vir elke dowe duivel, in Jesus naam, kom uit. En in die naam van die Heere Jezus ontbind ons in hierdie oomblik gesig vir die blindes. Heere, laat daar een heeling plaasvind. Laat die oore van die doves hoor. Ons lê ons hande op die verlamdes, op die kreupeles, op die vermoeides, op die gepynigdes. Ons sê vir elke kranke gees om te los. Die bloed van die lam het betaal. Golgotha was een werkelijkheid. En ons sê vir siektes kom uit swak liggame. Ons gebied om te los. En Heere, ons ontbind heling, ons ontbind genesing, ons ontbind die salving wat die hekke breek. Ons sê vir siek mense, die Heere maak u gezond. Ons sê vir siekes, die kracht van die Heere gaan deur u liggaam. Kom ons begin het te vat, kom ons begin die Heere te dank, reg oor hierdie plek. Oh, come on! Let's give Jesus the healer a good praise. Sick people, begin to clap your hands. Take your healing. Say, I take it through the blood of Jesus. Let's all say out loud, through the blood of Jesus,
the blood of Jesus,
I am healed.
I am healed.
I'm going to say that, deur die bloed van Jesus, is ek genees. Amen.
Amen.
Allemaal wie sy pijn weg is, allemaal wat kan loop, kan sien, kan hoor, wat geneesing ontvang het, stap uit naar die platform en kom vertel vir ons wat die Heere gedoen het. Werkers, toets die mense en bring hulle vir geneesing na die platform toe. Kom ons staan allemaal en ons sing heerlik saam. Praise God. Brother Archie, just lead us in some songs right now. We are waiting for the sick that are being healed to come forward and tell us what God has done for you. If you are healed, come right out and tell us what God has done. If you can hear and can see and can walk, if your pain has left, come forward and come and tell us. Workers, will you just go down and select the best testimonies for us? Blind eyes, deaf ears, crippled people. Heerlik saam, he was wounded
for our transgressions. He was bruised for our iniquities.
Van hierdie nuwe groep mense wat kom, blindes, dowes, skrepeles, kom reg hier na vore. Trappe toe. As jy doof was en jy kan hoor, kom hier na die trappe. As jy blind was en jy kan sien, kom hier na die trappe toe. As daar 'n groot wonderwerk met jy plaasgevind het, kom hier na die trappe toe.
Surely,
praise God.
Praise God. Listen to this wonderful testimony. Lady, tell the people what has happened.
Amen. Praise God. I can thank God tonight for touching my right ear. It was there for quite a long time, but I never been to the doctor, and I know Jesus can heal me, but praise the Son of God tonight, I can stand here on His word that He touched my ear. Amen.
Can you hear now?
Amen.
Right. Pastor Mickey Rodriguez is closing that side very closely.
Let me explain to you what we're going to do to prove this healing. I'm going to snap my finger. Hold this for me. I'm going to snap my finger at the deaf ear where she can't see me. And I'm going to ask her to indicate how many times I'm snapping. Now, I want you to look at me. When I snap my finger like this, if you hear it here, you want you to show me how many times I snap. I don't want to use a mic just because she's answering with her finger.
Take it away. Wat is happened with you? Is die Afrikaans?
Afrikaans.
Wat het met u gebeur?
Ek het vir 18 jaar aan my ma gelei, dat het baie klein begin. Die dokters kon nooit iets verkeerd vind nie, maar dat het erger en erger geword, en ek in die knop gevoel, en toe ek val, toe is dit weg, en nou is dit alles weg.
Hoe lang het jy die knop in jou ma gehad?
So ongeveer 5 jaar.
Was dit een vergroeisel wat jy kon voel?
Binnenin, ja.
Is dit?
Ja.
Jy kon het voel?
Ek kon het voel, en dit is nou weg. Dank.
Kom ons gee die Here prys daarvoor. Hoe lank was u doof?
Ek was omtrent die hele tyd doof en nou.
Sê vir my hoe lank? Luister wat ek vra, 5 of 10 of 3, hoeveel jaar?
5 jaar.
Wat 'n oor?
Al twee ore.
Wat 'n een was die doofste?
Die ene.
Regterkant. Was hy heeltemal doof of gedeeltelik?
Nee, dit was nie heeltemal doof.
Is hy nou oop?
Ja.
Is dit? Gaan ons gee die Here prys vir die genesing. Meneer Gous, wat was fout met u gewees?
Die onderse rugwervel van my het uitgespring. Ek kan my rug gebuig na my linkerkant of na my regterkant toe.
Sê vir my, was jy vir dokters ondersoeke?
Ek was vir dokters ondersoek.
Het jy plate gehad?
Ek het die plate by my, maar ongelukkig het ek die nou hierso.
Is dit? En wat was die dokterse bevinding?
Dokterse bevinding was wees, as die recht kom nie, sal hulle moet opereer om die wervels terug te kry.
Is dit? En wat het vanavond gebeur?
Ek het net 'n warm gloed op my rug gevoel en kan net my rug in enige rigting.
Kon jy swaar goed optel? Kon jy swaar goed optel?
Nee, ek kan glad nie swaar goed optel.
Ok, staan so voor. Staan nie, van hom sy lyf, tel hom op. Voel het nou, buig weer vooroor. Gaan weer na die kante toe. Is daar geen pyn nie?
Niks, en ek gaat morgen na die therapie toe, laat sy bevestig van kan.
Is dit? So jy gewaar, jy kon nie so swaar gewig optel?
Ek kan nie, ek het my rug seer gemaak net om van my motor se stoot, net 'n ligte stootjie.
Ek sien. En dan, maar nou kon nie daai gewig optel.
Ek kan opstel, het geen pyn.
Geen pyn hoegenaamd nie. Kan aan alle kante toe beweeg. Tel hom net weer op. En buig weer vir ons. Kyk na die wonderwerk wat die Here gedoen het. Buig weer. Gaan na die kante toe. Kyk daar. That's a good miracle. He couldn't do that at all. He's got x-rays of this, but God has healed him. Let's give Jesus a good clap of him. Wat was verkeerd met jou gewees?
Ek kan precies nie sê nie, maar die dag toe ek my oë ontwaak, toe ek die dag gaan om te gaan werk soek, Toe sê hulle, wat ek is nie geskik om te werk nie.
Wat was verkeerd? Kyk vir my, antwoord net my vraag. Wat was verkeerd aan jou?
Ek was verlam.
Aan watter kant?
Aan die linkerkantse arm.
Linkerkantse arm. Hierdie man sê hy was lam aan die linkerkantse arm gewees. En wat het gebeur terwyl ons bid?
Toe was daar lieflike lewe, laat die lewe nou nog in my arm is.
Steek jou arm op. Maak hom oop, maak hom toe. Steek hom op. Steek hom, haal hom, waai hom bietjie rond. Welkom, ons gee die Here prys daarvoor. Wat het met u gebeur, meneer?
Oor 20 jaar het my oor wat hy nou in u kan doof is.
20 years deaf on the right side. 20 jaar, nee. U kon glad niks hoor hierdie kant.
Ek kan hapat hoor, jy weet, maar nou hoor ek beter.
En hierdie kant is dit. Sal iemand net hierdie kant goed kom toemaak? Met 'n vinger en 'n sakdoek en wat jy ook al kan. Elke keer as jy my hand, my vinger kan oorklap, sê net ja.
Ja. Ja. Ja. Ja. Ja. Ja. Praise the Lord. Ek kan hoor. Die Here het my genees. Dankie Jesus. Ek kan hoor. Ek hoor is op. Halleluja. Prys die Here.
Amen. Kom ons gee die Here prys vir hierdie genees. Kom ons hoor wat die Here hier gedoen het.
Doop in my oor gewees, my linkeroor.
Watter kant hierdie kant?
Linkerkant.
Wat het gebeur nou?
Ek net iets warm gevoel in my oor.
En nou?
Nou kan ek hoor.
Prys die Here. Kom ons gee die Here 'n dankie vir hierdie geneesing. Amen. Luister, wat het die Here vir jou gedoen, mevrou? Wat het u bekeer?
Ek het vergroeide rugwervels en vergroeide nekwervels.
En wat was die toestand wat dit veroorsaak?
My nek en my rug was styf en ek het baie pyn gehad gedurig.
Haar nek en rug was styf met gedurige pyn. Wat het gebeur toe ons gebid het?
Ek het net gevoel die krag van die Here deur my gaan en dat die pyn verdwyn en dat ek met eens kan voel ek is gesond.
En wat kan u nou u nek en rug beweeg? Buig u rug laat ons sien. Kom ons gee die Here prys daarvoor. That's a good healing. Hierdie dametjie het 'n vergroeisel op haar gewrig gehad.
I couldn't move my hand.
What's your name?
Connie Birch.
Did you have a growth on your arm?
I had a glandian for 2 months.
A glandian.
I had 2 removed already, and I knew the Lord was going to heal me.
You couldn't move your arm?
No, I couldn't. No.
What has happened?
The Lord has healed me.
Is it?
Yes.
And you are completely able to move that arm again? Let's give God all the glory for it. Listen to this miracle. Tell us what was wrong.
Deaf and dumb.
He was deaf and dumb. You were deaf and dumb. You couldn't hear. Deaf and dumb.
You can hear now. Dang. 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 Dang.
Kom ons staan, ons gee die Here prys. Hy's 'n doofstom man wat nou kan hoor en sy gesprek, sy spraak sal terugkeer. I tell you, this is a good miracle. Is there anybody that knows him in this place? Is hier iemand wat hom ken? Steek op die hand of sien. Come here if you know him. Do you know him, lady? What's his name? His father. Is hy sy father? You are his pastor. What is your name, pastor? Pastor Swartz. You can testify and verify that this man was deaf and dumb. Is that right? He couldn't hear. Nothing. Nothing at all. That is his pastor, and his pastor says this man couldn't hear at all. Now listen, look at this. Now I must tell you something. This man must learn
to talk again like a little baby. He's never heard sound in his whole life. Let us just remain standing in the presence of the Holy Spirit. Come on. Hierdie persoon sal moet leer praat, want sy brein het twee klanke verwerk nie, maar hy kan nou hoor en hy gaan leer praat. Dit vat 'n babietjie 2 jaar om te praat, maar ek sê vir binne 2 jaar gaan hierdie man net so vlot praat as wat hy kan hoor. Maar kom ons kyk wat die Here vir hom gedoen het. Kan jy hoor nou?
Daar. Ja.
As jy my hand kan hoor, dan maak jy ook een. As ek sê, dan klap jy ook een. As ek klap, jy moet klap wat jy hoor.
Okay.
As ek lang gelede maak, maak hy lang gelede. As ek kortetjies maak, maak hy kortes. Dit beteken hy kan hoor. En die Here gaan hom leer praat. Kom ons gee die Here prys vir hierdie besondere wonderwerk.